Okay, so we're going to talk about having gas when you're doing keto and when you're doing intermittent fasting, okay? You didn't have gas before, and now you do, okay? What are the possibilities? Well, it could be you're introducing new vegetables that you're not used to, like the cruciferous vegetables. A lot of people are not used to consuming that, and they start eating all this kale or cabbage or broccoli, and they just gas out. So you're going to have to either change the vegetables that you're consuming, consume them a little more fermented or steamed, okay? That should handle that. Number two, it could be the sugar alcohols, the alternative sugars, like erythritol is a big one. It's like a laxative. You have xylitol, and there's a bunch more that can create digestive issues, okay, in gas. And also that fiber, like an inulin. Inulin, not insulin, inulin, is in a lot of, it's like a prebiotic. It's like a fiber in sometimes chocolate and other products that you would get that are keto-friendly. That can create a lot of bloating and gas, okay? It could also be the low-carb ingredients like the almond flour that you're not used to consuming that can now create a problem because you went on Pinterest and you found this great recipe and you made it with these alternative ingredients. You're just not used to it. That's probably why you're getting gas. And then lastly, it's the low stomach acid. If your stomach acid is not strong enough, you're not going to digest the protein and you're going to get gas. And the way you would know that you need more stomach acid is if you have indigestion, acid reflux, gas, bloating, and the food just is not digesting very fast, especially after consuming protein. Okay, in which case you'd want to consume more apple cider vinegar. You can get it as a tablet or betaine hydrochloride, which is an acidifier. You can find it at the health food store. All right, thanks for watching. Hey, thank you so much for watching. Keep spreading the word and share this video.